better place. We have 40 days to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. By the help of God, to make our world a better place.
Student, hope you're doing good, hope you're safe at home. So today I want to learn this subject on physics. What is physics? Now that is a question on form one. Answer yourself while at home. Today I want to discuss on the capacitors. What is capacitors? What do you understand by the term capacitor? So maybe you have gotten a chance to open your radio at home, a spoiled radio at home. Maybe you have ever seen there are those many things that are there mounted on the down part. So those are the examples of capacitors and resistors. There are so many. You can see small things like cylinder form like. So those are the capacitors and resistors. So today on this topic, I wish we talk on the capacitors. Ask yourself, what is a capacitor? I'm going to answer you for today, but next time I'm the one who's going to answer me that question. What is a capacitor? So a capacitor, these are the devices that are used to store the electric charges. They are devices used to store electric charges. So write that. So they are devices used to store electric charges. Used to store electric charges. Knowing that, I think you're in the better position. You can be told in an exam, and it's not a new question. It has been there, it was there, and it will still be there for you. What is a capacitor? So, a capacitor, in simple terms, you say this are devices used to store electric charges. You must state the term electric charges. When I'm marking, it is there to store. Yeah, it is used to store. It's not used to produce. So when I'm marking that answer, I'm looking the word to store. Number two, I'm not just marking the word charges. I'm interested on the electric charges. So the second mark comes here. So when I'm marking, number one, the marks is to see if you know it is used to store. The second one, they are used to store what? They are used to store electric charges. Knowing that, I think the two marks, you have all of them. Thank you for understanding me. The next thing, and what do we now? We go to the arrangement. How does the arrangement goes like? Number one, let's start with the series arrangement. Series arrangement. These are very common questions in paper 2 when it comes to the form 4 work, to the form 3 works. When you have started now doing the full papers, these are very common questions on paper 2. So, on the series arrangement, for example, when vehicles are going to one direction, they are in the series arrangement. So that is series, because they are using one line. But when two vehicles are moving the opposite direction, that is parallel. But today, let's focus on the series arrangement. Number one, do you know the symbol that is used to refer to the capacitor? I'm going to tell you. So the symbol that we use on the capacitor is this one. Now you have seen, there is a difference between the two sticks. When you are dealing with a cell, let me touch on that. A cell. We have a cell, the symbol for cell, one is smaller to the other one. this will first positive this, but when it comes to the capacitor, the sticks, all these two sticks, they are of the same height. So that's the difference between the cell symbol and the capacitor symbol. Hope you have gotten the difference. Thank you. The next thing, the series arrangement. How is it? For example, you can have the several capacitor. So capacitor number one, capacitor number two, and capacitor number three. So let's say, like here, it's 1.5 microfarads. That's the SI unit of the capacitor. The second one is 2 microfarads. And the third one is 3 microfarads. Knowing that, now, then, we complete the circuit. Let's say here we have a cell, 12.0 volts. Now that is an example I want to calculate. Another thing you're supposed to know, that when you are calculating the total or the effective and capacitor in the series arrangement, you are supposed to know that for you to get the total capacitor is equals to the reciprocal of the first capacitor, which we refer as C1, the reciprocal of the second capacitor, which we call it C2, and the reciprocal of the third capacitor, which we refer as the C3. So the reciprocal of the third capacitor, which we call it C3. So knowing now this, so in your notebook, can you note that formula? It is a very simple formula. Because you know series, you just get the reciprocal of the capacitor that you have been given. So solution. Let's look at the solution. Solution. You have been told find. The question was find the total capacitance. Find in the arrangement. In the arrangement, calculate or find the total capacitor in the arrangement. So what are you going to do? Number one, you're going to know this formula. You have the three. So we say 1 over Ct is equals to 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 plus 1 over C3. Now, because you have the formula and you have the values given. C1 have given is 1.5 microfarads, 2.0 microfarads, and the last one is 3 microfarads. So from there, what are you going to do? So you say is equals to 1 all over 1.5 plus 1 all over C2 is equals to 2.0 plus 1 over 3.0. And then, now using your calculator, 1 over 1 plus 1, 1 over 1.5 plus 1 over 2.0 plus 1 over 3.0, you get what? You do at your own. And then, after I did it for you, only for today, I got 3 all over 2. I got 3 over 2. Can you use your calculator very well? You are going to observe that we have gotten 3 over 2. So we say our 1 over Ct is equals to 3 over 2. Most of students, they leave it at that point, but that's not correct. This, when you're marking, these are 3 marks question. 3 marks question. So I'm going to mark number 1. In physics, we mark formula. You get 1 mark. So I give you 1 mark. Number 2. Have you known how to substitute correctly? Yeah. I give you another 1 mark. So those are 2 marks. And then the last mark is on the answer. Now, if you read this, I'm going to give you an X and I give you a 0 mark. Reason being why? 1 over CT is equals to 3 over 2. What are you supposed to know? The question was, find the total capacitor in the arrangement. Find the total capacitance in the arrangement. So, this is 1 over the total capacitance. So, for us to get the CT, what are you going to do? What are you supposed to do? 1 over CT. We want to get CT. Our question was to get the CT, the total capacitance. T, I'm referring to as the total or the effective capacitance. So, I want to get this one. So the best thing, can you get the reciprocal of both? Or you can just cross multiply, but for me, I won't advise you to cross multiply. Reason being, I want you to get the reciprocal. So if I get the reciprocal of 1 over CT is equals to CT is equals to what? I want to get also the reciprocal of the second, of the this one, 3 over 2. The reciprocal is equals to what? 3 over 2 is equals to what? The reciprocal, it becomes 2 all over 3. The reciprocal of 3 over 2 is equals to 3 over 2. So, in physics, don't fill your answer into fraction. Make your answers into decimal form. So, it's equals to 0.67. And remember, it was in microfarad. So, we say the total capacitor is equals to 0.6767 microfarads. 6.7 microfarads. Hope you have enjoyed my class. See you next time. Thank you very much.